Welcome to France and Eurobasket Women 2013. 15 days of action, 16 of the very best teams all battling it out for one prize. The first round of the competition taking place in Vannes and here in Trélazay. Let's see who survives the initial stage. France off to the perfect start in their first round group. Les Bleus, backed by a fanatical home support throughout the tournament, starting off in some style with the destruction of Latvia and Serbia in their opening two games in Group C. The Serbs immediately in real trouble. They fell to 0-2, but they held their nerve, knocking out Latvia in a winner-take-all game to move on to the second phase. Group D very even, Belarus and Czech Republic with high hopes, Croatia probably too. But it was Lithuania who became the first side to be eliminated after two straight losses at the outset. The Czechs coping despite a loss through injury to Jane Vesela, regrouping and moving on. Group A in Vannes, where Turkey began their bid to reach a second straight European final. Three wins out of three for them, Montenegro and Slovakia scrapping their way through also. But disappointment for Ukraine, Europe's Young Player of the Year, Alina Ajupova, ending her stay in France without a win. Group B, where Spain started on their mission to reign supreme. No problems for them, but the major shock of round one coming here. Three sides ending up deadlocked on 1-1 records, and on the tiebreaker, it was Sweden and Italy who progressed. And Russia, the Eurobasket champions from 2011, waving goodbye to their title and heading home after just three games. So four teams have gone home, 12 left surviving into round two, which takes place in Lille and here in Vendée. And all of them are hoping to survive and shoot their way through into the knockout stages. Spain began round two as they ended round one in emphatic style with an easy win over Slovakia in Group E. Turkey, their chief rivals, breezing past Italy, but behind the top two, a fight for survival that would go right to the last games. Italy battling past Montenegro to advance into the last eight, and then it all came down to Sweden. A win for them would send them through, but they had to give it everything to keep their dreams alive. Victory by just 3 points over Slovakia, enough to put them into their first quarter-final for 25 years, and send the Slovaks and Montenegrins on their way home. But just one more question to be answered. Who would finish top, Spain or Turkey? Answer, the Spanish. Sancho Little with 18 points and 13 rebounds in a resounding 61-48 win. Over in Vendée, France maintaining their march. Three more wins, but Serbia continuing to surprise. Ana Dabovic playing through a knee injury, but wins over Belarus and the Czech Republic enough to extend their adventure. Belarus and the Czechs inconsistent, just doing enough to survive. Great Britain, though, missing out on a tiebreaker for fourth place in Group F. Joanna Leedham underlining her credentials as one of Europe's best. The GB joining Croatia and waving us goodbye.
So we bid farewell and au revoir to four more teams from France, and now eight just left standing in the race to become champion of Eurobasket Women for 2013. And now we arrive at our final destination, Orsi, and the Pavel Arena, the site for the knockout stages. Three more victories will see you crowned as champion of Europe, but will it be these guys who end up holding the trophy?
Serbia, Italy, the first tie, a game of runs, but the last word came to the Serbs, coming up big in the fourth quarter behind Jelena Milovanovic to make sure they progressed. Spain versus Czech Republic up next, and the Albatorin show. A huge early lead for Las Rojas, and then a comeback from the Czechs. But then, Sancho Little, coming up huge, and the Spanish pulled away to win by 17. Turkey-Belarus always destined to be a physical battle, no quarter asked, none given. The Turks left it late, but pulled away, as Sezeye Evergin struck gold to fire them through. Last, but not least, France-Sweden, and what proved to be the game of the tournament. Les Bleus favourites, the Swedes huge underdogs, but playing like warriors. France up 10 early on, looking very comfortable. Sweden fighting back, 1 point in front at half time. It became a scrap to stay alive, the search to land that killer blow. And as so often as before, it was Céline Dumerc who took the role of assassin. Three light three-pointers guiding the French to safety. For the Swedes, tears and sadness as their hopes of an upset slipped away. So, just four teams left. The semi-finals, pairing Spain against Serbia, and the Spanish determined not to relent. A 10-0 start putting them in control, and they never gave up. Sancho Little with 22 points and 11 rebounds dominating inside. Serbia unable to match up, the defence too strong, and it was España who moved on into their first final since 2007, as the Serbians' fairy tale came to its end. But who would the Spanish face? Turkey, France, a repeat of the 2011 semi, but the result different this time. The hosts, fueled by marching bands and dancing fans, going into a 12-2 lead. Beautiful play, but then it became ugly. A real grind. Turks fighting back. Esmeril Tunçler on fire. French ambitions quelled. Just 2 points separated the teams heading into the final quarter. The game in the balance, but France pulling it out. Collective sigh of relief in Orsi, but they live to fight on through to the tournament's last day. So the final weekend, three classification games. Sweden, paced by Frida Eldebrink, such an impressive presence in the tournament, left it late, but saw off Italy to take seventh. The Czech Republic and Belarus already claiming their spots at next year's FIBA World Championships. Belarus, though, determined to leave with one more win. And so it proved, Yelena Yuchanka supreme, as the Belarusians made sure they ended up fifth. A bronze medal, the consolation prize, for Turkey and Serbia in focus. The chance to end up third, and even without Ana Davovic, the Serbs out to write one more fairy tale. A solid start from them, up 7 points early in the opening period. Turkey, the runners-up 2 years ago, soon finding the range. 19 points coming from Yveri Yilmaz. Serbia looking inside, 1 point in front at half-time. But the Turks indomitable after the break, a 14-0 run taking them clear, the shots starting to fall. And although Jelena Milovanovic had a game-high 23 points, it didn't prove enough. The Turks seeing a way forward, another 11-0 burst tightening their grip. In the end, Serbia just couldn't keep up. Bersel Bardali coming up big in the second half, 17 points. And as Turkey rolled away, Serbia forced to settle for a creditable fourth. The Turks leaving France on a winning note, celebrations, but still
just one game left. Two teams arriving with one mission in common, to be the ones walking out of Pavel Arena with the Eurobasket Women trophy in their possession. France and Spain ready to give it everything they've got in the tournament finale. The European title here and now on the line.
France immediately trying to seize the initiative, Sandrine Gruda giving Les Bleus an early lead. But Alba Torrens in the zone, 21 points for her in the game, but with bigger returns in mind. France struggling to generate opportunities. Their France, however, relentless throughout, their support unwavering. Spain leaving them on edge though, Sancho Little a towering presence. And Las Rojas, unafraid, going up by 12 in the second period. Torrens maintaining her own push, landing one big shot after another. Pierre Vincent remaining composed, his trust in Céline Dumerc unwavering. The playmaker sparking a 13-0 run, game on once more, and the French trailing by just one at half-time. Another charge needed by the Spanish, Silvia Dominguez leading the way, another 6-0 burst, but the drama in Orsi far from over. 9 lead changes in total, the fans willing the French to survive. But Little, magnificent, an MVP showing, 20 points, 11 rebounds, a massive impact. One last chance, fans down 3, 2, just not enough. Sundering Gruda a game-high 25 points, but despair for her, ecstasy for Spain. France so close but so far, but for the Spanish, a 20-year wait for a European title comes to an end. So an amazing 2 weeks of basketball come to an end. A lot of credit goes to those tireless volunteers working behind the scenes and to the fantastic fans in France who came along in huge numbers and made so much noise.
It's Spain who are celebrating here in Orsi. They are the champions of Eurobasket Women for 2013. In 2 years' time, it will be Hungary and Romania's turn to host the championships. But from here in France, it's farewell.